sure they probably thought, oh my God, what are we getting into now with her? Because I was constantly on the go. I was always getting into trouble, into everything. Wouldn't sit still. Now, my brother, on the other hand, Mom could sit him on the floor, and he would stay there. He wouldn't move. That's where he would stay. I think, as you know, as growing up, you know, with Mom, especially with Mom, I struggled in school. I didn't get the brains of the family like my brother did, or my brothers did. And I struggled in school. And thank goodness for Mom, because she was right there next to me, got me through all of school, and got me so that I could graduate from high school. And then I eventually got done high school, and I surprised the heck out of my mom because they figured that I would probably just, you know, become a secretary or, you know, go off and work. Well, I came home one day and said, Mom and Dad, I'm going to nursing school. So that was the start of that. And actually, my love of nursing came from my mom, because that was something that my mom always wanted to be, was a nurse, and was never able to do that. So I guess I fulfilled my mother's dream of being a nurse. And it's something that I would never, ever give up. It's a passion of mine also. And same with the horses. You know, Mom always loved the horses. She rode as a young girl, saving her babysitting money and riding. And I guess I got that from her too, because I'm, as probably most of you know, I'm still riding and still have a horse. Yeah, well, not like you, brother. But
I took it about 20 times.
Family was everything to Mom. And same with my dad too. You know, family was everything. You know, on the weekends as we were growing up, it was a whole family affair. We went to horse shows together. We did all kinds of things together. Family was just, like I said, our family.
That's how we acquired Bud.
Yep. That's how he came into our world and into our life. I don't know what else to say about Mom. She was the backbone of the family. No matter what happened, no matter what, she was always there for us. I guess that's all I can say. That she was always, always there for us as kids and growing up. And even after we got, you know, moved away and went on with our own lives, she was always there.
Yeah.
She was always there for us. And one thing that I really miss right now, I mean, is on my way to work every night, I would call her. And I would talk to her from the time I pulled out of the driveway at home to the time I pulled in the parking lot at the hospital. And we would talk about everything. You know, what was going on in my life, how Michael was doing, how Julia was doing. We solved all kinds of world problems. At least we thought we did. You know, and then she talked about her favorite show, which was The Dancing with Stars. I got to know the people on Dancing with Stars, the professional dancers, not because I watched the show, it's just because Mom would talk about it all the time. Oh, I'm sorry. So
thank you.
Her Dancing with the Stars was like one of her favorite shows.
And she never trusted the judges when they added the points.
Yes,
she
I know.
Went to our house.
Oh, yes, I
she
know.
She would get her tablet and she would and make sure they had the scores added.
And I would hear about it too.
Yes.
I would
yes.
hear about how the judges scored the dancers. And she says, I can't believe they won. Because when I calculated the scores and everything, this couple should have won. And it was funny to hear her talk about the show. I mean, she was just very passionate about it. And she would call. There was a phone number you could call.
She did.
And she would vote. Call for, you know, for, you know, you could, who her favorite people were. So that was just, I mean, we talked about everything going when I was going into work. And, you know, shortly after she passed away, I, out of habit, because it was something that we did, I you know, I had the hands-free thing, and I said, call mom. And then after I did it, I'm like, I can't talk to her anymore. You know, and that was the hardest thing to get over, is not having her to talk to every night when I went to work. So I guess
I still have her number in my speed dial.
I do too. I do too. So. You?
I don't have too much more to add in addition to what Melissa said. I've been blessed to be part of this amazing family for close to 40 years. And, you know, in addition to family, which was everything to Mother, her friends and her faith were the other two things. I always describe her as, you know, she believed in the three F's, family, friends, and faith. And that is so true. And she maintained many friend relationships throughout her entire life, no matter where she lived. And she went and visited friends, and of course her biggest support network was here, which is where she's always called home. And so she's been very close to have this church and her church family here, and that's a comfort for me, knowing that we were so far away, that she was able to have her family and live her life the way she wanted to here. And so kudos to her. And I pray that she's now joined with our Father, because that is what she has wanted for the past 10 years. And so she's done her job. She knows that we're all fine. And she's moving on to fulfill her eternal life.
Yep. I can't say that I'm going to be looking at this or not, but I know my mom, last 2 years, through all my demise, with my kidneys and everything else, it was her faith that brought us through all this. So I was very happy that she knew before she passed that I was going to be okay. And I know her and Dad were there at surgery, watching over me from heaven. It was her faith that carried everybody through in this family, even with Dad's passing. And I truly believe, like the Pastor Doug said, that Mom never did recover completely from Dad's passing. They were that close. So I don't think she felt like she should still be in this world with him. And I'm truly blessed that through her faith that her and Dad are back together. Where she wanted to be.